The web shooter is one of the coolest and most iconic gadgets in pop culture. What's inside it? How does it work? And could something like this exist in real life? This is Diane X, and right now you'll find out how the web shooter works. Each Spider-Man has their own version of web shooters, but no matter the design, they all work on the same principle. Let's break down the simplest and most recognizable version, the one Peter Parker built in The Amazing Spider-Man from 2012. The basis of the web shooter is the web itself. It is stored in a special capsule. Inside is a bio cable from Oscorp, created from the silk of genetically modified spiders. Peter slightly altered the formula, adapting it for his purposes. One capsule holds hundreds of meters of thread under a pressure of about 20 atmospheres, roughly 300 psi. An electromechanical valve is attached to the web capsule. It prevents the web from being released without Peter's command. On the front of the device, a nozzle. There's that shapes the web into a stream when fired. Firing is triggered by a button built into his glove. When you press it with two fingers, the middle and ring, a signal is sent to the device. Inside the web shooter, there's a miniature circuit board that performs several functions. It receives a signal from the trigger, opens the valve on the capsule, and displays the remaining web level through LED indicators. The device is powered by a standard lithium battery. All the parts had to be compact and reliable, so Peter used components from old wristwatches. Now let's see how the shot happens. Peter presses the trigger button with his fingers, closing the contact. The signal from the button goes to the microcontroller. The controller opens the valve in the capsule with the web. The web is instantly ejected outside under high pressure. Passing through the nozzle, the web takes the form of a directed thread, which instantly solidifies, becoming strong and flexible. In the next movie, Peter improved his device. And here's the web shooter that Tony Stark built for Tom Holland's Spider-Man, featuring artificial intelligence and multiple web modes. Here's Tobey Maguire's version. And here's Peter's web shooter from Insomniac Games. This is Miles Morales' web shooter from the same game. Write in the comments which version you like best. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss future videos. And now for the big question. Is it actually possible to build web shooters in real life? Well, the device itself is fairly realistic. Some YouTube enthusiasts have already shown that. But when it comes to the web itself, things get complicated. Natural spider silk is an incredible material. Stronger than steel, lighter than plastic, elastic, and it doesn't twist when stretched. It may seem simple, just take a spider, connect a milking machine to it, create a spider farm, and collect the web. But no, most spiders don't live in colonies. They eat each other and the amount of silk they produce is tiny. But there are so-called social spider species. Most likely it was their genetically modified versions shown in the movie. That's why scientists are now focusing on synthetic alternatives. They managed to synthesize the spidroin protein, the basis of natural spider silk. From it, they make threads that are just as strong and elastic as the real thing. But even if we imagine that we already have the web, swinging like Spider-Man still wouldn't work. Because Peter has super strong muscles and reinforced bones. His body can handle massive G-forces. For the average person, such sudden pulls can cause serious injuries. Our bodies just aren't built for that. However, this kind of web could be used for other purposes. For example, to make ultralight body armor, ropes, or fasteners. Web shooters are undoubtedly one of the coolest superhero gadgets, simple and brilliantly engineered. But like any device on its own, it's just a tool. The true strength of Spider-Man isn't in his powers or gadgets. It's in his intelligence, his sense of responsibility, and his kind heart.